Hi, I'm Pablo Lopez, and I'm part of the Sysdig education team. Today we learn about Falco plugins.
Falco is the de facto cloud-native runtime security threat detection engine for containers and Kubernetes. Falco is able to detect threats observing the syscall activity of any given system. It helps enforce deep levels of security regardless of platform, from single Linux host to Kubernetes cluster. Battle forecast and trends show increasingly that workloads are deployed on cloud-native platforms. Although this new paradigm reduces cost and opens new possibilities, it also creates new risks that are not detected with a standard approach. For example, user authentication without enabling multi-factor, storage encryption is removed, or account login is disabled. These are just a few examples. As the set of capabilities that cloud vendors offer grows each quarter, the exposure surface is bigger, and security might be compromised in ways not previously considered. So how do you secure workloads on the cloud? Falco plugins is the answer. Falco plugins allow users to extend Falco to add new data sources and extend the current set of fields to support events from the new sources. So now, as a consequence of this, Falco adds a cutting-edge new feature, Cloud Security Threat Detection. Any event happening within your cloud vendor can be detected by Falco, and all of it following the same Falco demeanor that we all know, same tool configurations, same rule syntax, and same alerting channels. This means that you can keep the same Falco instance that is in use today and extend it with new sources. In general, Falco can ingest events from any given service that creates an audit log, but in particular, it targets the securing of cloud resources. Currently, there is support for AWS Cloudtrail and JSON files. Any login file in JSON format can be used as a source for Falco, but these are not a closed set of integrations. The architecture of Falco plugins enables the creation of new plugins. It can be extended to, for example, GCP Cloud Audit Logs, Azure Log Analytics, and IBM Cloud Platform Logs. Through Falco and Falco plugins, any action in a cloud account that is audited in a log engine is within scope to be included in a Falco rule. Let's see more about rules. Here you can find some examples of rules for a new Falco plugin. In this case, the detection is based on a new EC2 instance starting up. As you probably know, AWS Cloudtrail monitors and records account activity across your AWS infrastructure. It provides a structured view of all the important events in your AWS account. Let's see an example. This event here will trigger this rule. We can see that the event name is run instances. The source IP will be displayed in the output in the case that no error exists, along with other information, as the username and AWS region. Falco rules for a particular plugin will be using the set of fields defined by the plugin. Each new plugin will have its own supported fields. One of the advantages is that few changes are needed to the base Falco configuration. To enable Falco plugins, open the falco.yaml file and include the file with the plugin rules. Then configure the plugins. The different parameters to define a plugin depend on the plugin that will be used, but in general, it defines where the plugin driver is located and from where Falco should be ingesting the source of events. The load plugins options define which of the defined plugins are loaded at Falco start. Let's review also the different types of plugins. Falco supports two different types of plugins. The main difference between each type is from where events are ingested. This is a source plugin. It provides a new event source to Falco. It ingests events from an external source like, for example, AWS Cloudtrail. They have the ability to open and close streams of events. On the contrary, extractor plugins do not ingest events from an external source, but from other plugins, for example, the JSON plugin.
Now, you're ready to begin your journey on securing cloud with Falco. Thanks for watching, and we hope you enjoyed this video.